In this video, I'm gonna show you how to add seam allowance on your sleeve using Pant system. Hi, I'm Jean and welcome to Pattern Studio 101. I post pattern making tutorials every week. The videos are short and easy to digest. If you're interested in pattern making or want to learn pad program, please subscribe and hit the bell so you don't miss new lessons. This is a pad system tutorial. I'm going to show you how to add seam allowance onto your sleeve patterns. You will see what tools you can use and what kind of options you have in pad system. Let's jump in. Okay, here's the sleeve pattern. This is a short sleeve in plan view. To add seam allowance, you need to do set piece because you cannot add seam allowance on the plan view. You have to add seam allowance only on pieces. If you're wondering about what plan view is and what piece view is, the link will be at the end of this video or in the description box. So let's set piece. On the toolbar, you can find this guy, Seam Allowance. Select the tool and select the line you want to add seam allowance. Let's start with the hemline. While you have a seam allowance tool or any other tools, if you hold down the Control key, it shifts to the pointer tool. So you can select the line, and when you release the Control key, it goes back to seam allowance. Click anywhere on the line. Okay, let's take a look at what is in this dialog box. There's two types, constant, variable. We're gonna pick constant, but let's choose variable first so you can see what happens with this option. When you click variable, you see one more extra column appears. You can enter two different amounts on side one and side two. See, here's side 1, here's side 2. Pad assigns numbers automatically and it is always clockwise. Let's add value 1 inch on the side 1, 2 inches on the side 2. Click OK. Seam allowance is added 1 inch to 2 inches gradually. This is variable if you need this kind of seam allowance, but I rarely use this option. I'm gonna undo and click the line again. We're gonna choose constant, and I want 1 inch seam allowance, and I wanna add notches. So I'll check these two boxes because I want notches on both sides. If you click OK, you cannot see the notches for now. So let's add seam allowance on the sleeve inseam, half of an inch. And I want to have a notch on side 2. Click OK. You cannot see the notch that I just added, but you can see the notch that we added for the hem. The other side of inseam, the same way, half of an inch, and a notch on side 1. Now you can see both notches for the hem. I'm gonna select a sleeve cap and click anywhere on the line. Half of an inch seam allowance. I don't need notches here, so just click OK. Now you can see all the notches that I added. But as you can see, we have to fix this corner. With the pointer tool, select the corner. You see this dark part? And go to Menu, Treatment, Item Info. There is a shortcut, Control-I. Dialog box comes up, Seam Corner Characteristics. It is checked on standard now. The first option, hem symmetry on side 1, you see the blue numbers pad assigned. If you cannot see them very clearly, as I said, the numbers are always clockwise. So in this case, the hemline is number one, sleeve inseam is number two. We are gonna mirror the seam allowance by hemline, which is number one. So I check the first box and click OK. See? It's fixed. Let's do the other side. Select the corner, Control I, this time the second box because the hemline is number two now. See, sleeve inseam is number one and hemline is number two. Click OK. You have notches on both sides and a symmetric hemline. That's the seam allowance we want for sleeve hem. I'm going to show you how to add seam allowance on a blazer in the future episode. When you have a princess line, the corners are kind of tricky. And if you have front facing, you want to cut out the hem corner because it's bulky. So you will see more options for some different types of corners. Here's some videos about pad program. If you like this video, please give me thumbs up. Have a beautiful week, guys. See you next time.